Anyone who has followed the Wildlife Brothers for any length of time would know that we are fascinated by birds, and there is a great reason for this. Birds are among the most diverse and adaptable groups of animals, and they have evolved to suit just about every habitat on Earth. Our goal with this episode is to showcase the incredible adaptability of the birds of Costa Rica by following some of our birding expeditions through three very different habitats: an area of open grassy plains, old-growth tropical rainforest, and the peak of one of the tallest volcanoes in Costa Rica. Each habitat is home to bird species that are perfectly suited to their environment, and they truly exemplify the diversity and specialization that exists among avian life. To learn more about the adaptation, biology, and behavior of these amazing animals, let's take a trip across Costa Rica and see what kind of birds call these varied habitats home. If there is one group of birds that has carved a niche for itself in every habitat in Costa Rica, it would definitely be the pigeons and doves. With around 24 species documented in the country, there was no shortage of birds to film, and we came across three different species from this family. The first was a familiar sight to us, the common ground dove. Found in many different areas across North, Central, and South America, this species has truly earned the moniker common. We first came across the common ground dove in the British Virgin Islands, and it was really cool to see these guys in another location in a different part of the world. If you guys want to see our experiences birding in the Caribbean, there's a link in the description below. Another species we found was the white-winged dove. Also found across much of the southwestern US and Central America, the white-winged dove can be found in almost any open habitat, though they are especially prevalent in grassy scrublands or urban environments. They feed on seeds and fruits, so areas of farmland make very popular habitats for these doves. The final species we encountered was the red-billed pigeon, yet another pigeon species found in open grassy habitats. Primarily an herbivore, red-billed pigeons feed on seeds and berries mostly. They have a beautiful maroon coloration to their bodies, which sets them apart from many of the other pigeons and doves in their family. All of these guys were fun to film and demonstrated the diversity of birds that can be found in open habitats, an area that most people would think of as barren. While hiking through a grassy area between two stands of trees, we managed to come across one very acrobatic little bird, the blue-black grass quit. The energetic jumping behavior that he is displaying is part of his mating rituals. He jumps high into the air and calls out to potential mates, and he will defend his breeding territory adamantly from other imposing males. This little guy even managed to attract the attention of a female. Their long legs allow them to perch on blades of grass to perform their breeding displays, and their call is very distinct, in this case letting any females in the area know that this guy is ready to mate. Blue-black grass quits are found all over Central and South America, and their unique antics make them an adorable and entertaining species to observe. As we pushed deeper into the rainforest, we were met with a host of new bird species to encounter, a number of neotropical passerines. Passerines are birds that have the anatomical ability to perch on branches, species such as finches, sparrows, and other songbirds. Our explorations yielded some really cool finds from this family, including a type of bird known as a saltator. Saltators are songbirds in the tanager family, and we observed two species, the grayish saltator and the black-headed saltator. They are seed-eating birds found throughout the tropical Americas. Another passerine we saw is the blue-gray tanager, a relative of the saltators and a common species in the country. Finally, we filmed the chestnut-backed ant bird and the dot-winged ant wren, two insectivorous birds in the ant bird family, both found across Central and South America. All of these birds were new finds for us, and it was very exciting to see them in the wild for the first time. To reach our final destination, we had to ascend many thousands of feet in elevation. As you climb higher above the lower habitats, the species of animals you can encounter changes drastically. One species we found at the cusp between tropical and montane habitats is the sooty thrush. These guys are found only in the highlands of Costa Rica and Panama, usually above 2,200 meters in elevation. Sooty thrushes inhabit forests and forest edges, and they forage for insects and small fruits. We found this guy in a wildlife sanctuary poking around the lodge, and his personable disposition and beautiful colors instantly made him a favorite of ours.
So we're here on the Irasu volcano here in Costa Rica, and it's about, what, 50 degrees, would you say? It's really, really cold, even though it's summer here. Now we're about maybe 11, 12,000 feet, so it's really cool, and you can see the plant life here is completely different from the rainforests we've been exploring. We're out here looking for birds, actually. It's way too cold for reptiles, and this is just the most alien-looking landscape we have ever seen, guys, so we're gonna keep exploring and see if we can find any birds, because it is very cold out here.
Once we arrived at the top of Volcano Irasu, the landscape changed completely. The birds up here have to deal with extremely rapid temperature shifts, strong winds, and scarce food resources at certain times. Despite this, species like the rufous-collared sparrow flourish in this extreme habitat, and they are truly successful little birds. In fact, their range extends from southern Mexico all the way down to the Tierra del Fuego in Chile, essentially across the entire continent of South America. They can be found in almost any habitat across this range, but they are very prevalent in high-altitude habitats, such as the volcano that we were exploring. They are opportunistic feeders, consuming insects, seeds, berries, and anything else they can find on the slopes. They are also perfectly adapted to life in high elevations, able to regulate their body temperature and control their heart rate according to the ambient temperature. Rufous-collared sparrows are pretty tame birds, and they provided us with some great shots as we explored the peak of the volcano. Because the volcano habitat is so isolated and unique, there are a number of species endemic only to that area and type of habitat. Such is the case for the volcano junco, a member of the sparrow family found on open, sparsely vegetated volcanic slopes. This species is native only to Costa Rica and western Panama, so we were very fortunate to get it on camera. Volcano juncos are omnivorous, feeding on seeds, berries, and insects that they find on the slopes of the volcano. They've evolved to function perfectly in this high-altitude ecosystem, and they are an incredible example of the adaptability of birds. They have ashy gray plumage that blends in perfectly with the surrounding landscape, and their organs and muscles are well-suited to function efficiently in the high elevations of their montane habitat. Volcano juncos are not commonly seen birds, and for us, they were definitely an unexpected highlight of our birding adventures. One of the reasons birding is so rewarding is that there are so many fascinating species to observe, and an expedition into literally any ecosystem is bound to yield sightings of some of those birds. No matter where you go in Costa Rica, a host of different bird species can be seen, and each one is specially adapted to survive in this diverse little country. Studying these birds in the wild was an incredible experience. We were able to film some common species and some incredibly rare ones all in one birding adventure. Having now seen our experiences, it is our hope that the next time you are out in the wild, you will pay attention to the avian wildlife that surrounds you, because it can provide an amazing window into life in the natural world. If you enjoyed this episode of our Costa Rican adventure and are excited for more, leave us a like on the video and comment down below which tropical species you'd like to see most. There is so much more coming, so remember to subscribe to the Wildlife Brothers and stay tuned, everyone. The wait, I must say, is most definitely worth it. See you soon, guys!
The vegetation is so weird in Costa Rica. It's so alien-like.